Hey everyone, I'm going to show you all what we're after with our climate change preparedness plan for the for our horse farm. I'm showing you here, this is a piece of honeysuckle right in front of us here that needs to be removed. But you can see too, there's a lot of overgrowth here and cedars are everywhere. They all have to be cut down because they're invasive as well. And I'm actually gonna walk you through a few places. The idea is we get out rid of the invasive species and then create bioswales. We'll be able to retain water and help the proper vegetation grow in the area. So you're gonna see we're gonna clear, like, all of these cedar trees will be cleared. These big guys up here, of course, we'll keep those. The rule of thumb that we're coming up with is basically if they stand on their own, they're allowed to grow. If they're in a big group, they're not allowed to grow. So this is a great example here where you can see there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, maybe 10 of these trees here that we will end up out of all 10 of those, just keeping one. You can see our pond is down the hill here. There are 6 or 7 ecosystems on the property. That's one of them, of course. This is also one of them. What's really interesting is there's not as much honeysuckle or blackberry here as there are in other portions of our property. Some of it may be that it's rocky, some of it may be that it's the north-facing or a north-facing slope. So it doesn't get a ton of sunlight. I'm not entirely sure. We're gonna head over this way and head into an area that we have cleared. We're actually having a farm work day today and a bunch of it's being cleared today too. Woo, walking on trees. So the a lot of this was cleared 2 years ago now, and you can see we're starting to get some regrowth here. So these are some blackberries that are going to have to be recut. There's a few cedars that are real short that have started back in. The honeysuckle, of course, remains a really big problem, long-term problem. So that is going to take, unfortunately, it's probably going to take some pesticide to kill it, or herbicide to kill it. It's not a, it's one of those things where you cut it and you paint the stump so that it doesn't end up sticking around for too long. It's not able to grow back. You can see our herd down there and the farm proper. So these bioswales that we're talking about creating, the horses have actually created some of them here already. I'm actually walking on one right now. I'll show you that in just a moment and be able to show you up and down the hill too. And you'll be able to see them all. So these hills are steep enough that the horses don't like to go straight up and down them. They'll go straight up them, but they much rather work their way around to go up and down them. So they, if you look here, we're standing on a bioswale right here. And then if you look up the hill, you can see several more of them come up. So there's, let's see if I can point one there, 2, 3, 4. That cedar up there, of course, will have to come out. And you can see all the clearing that's going on now too. And then if you look down, you'll see that there's 1, 2, 3, 4 bioswales on the way down too. These were all created by horses. Our goal is to create them, create additional ones. And the whole idea behind the bioswale is that water comes down the hill during rainstorms and gets caught on the swale and then sticks and allows for vegetation growth. And then there's an overflow that then carries everything further down the hill if it ends up being too much water. You can see our herd over there eating hay, her very, very expensive hay as a result of the drought that we experienced last fall. So we're paying just incredible premiums right now. So this is the first part of the property that we'll restore. There's another portion over here I'll show you. I'm gonna go buy a chainsaw, so you might not be able to hear me that clearly, but I'll show you what we're doing. This is an example right here in front of us of a tree we're actually gonna keep. And you'll see it's helping hold the bioswale in place. So you can see where the ledge is there, right by the tree, and that the tree is actually giving it some support. And then going across, I'm gonna go across this way. We have three wet weather streams on our property, which we're gonna take advantage of, absolutely. We're gonna go through one of the ravines right now, right past this chainsaw here, so you're not gonna be able to hear me all that well. So I'll show you the property and then come back so that we can talk a little bit more. So it's here we go. So you can see this is the back of the property. But I say the back, this is what we call the back pasture. And here's one of our runoff creeks. This has all been cleared today, which is just amazing. But this last year was covered in cedar and overgrowth of various small trees and locust, and I'm trying to think what else, but lots of them. And so everything that could be cleared last year or 2 years ago was cleared. And you can see now what we have to do is go through and clear the rest, anything else that has come back up before we create these bioswales on this pasture, which it's gonna need a lot of help. You can see the lines are much more ravine-like in this pasture as opposed to the other one, which has had the horses on it for so long that it has its own bioswales. So this is just the front half of the property. The back of the property we have not touched yet. It is over top of this ridge. There is a pasture on top of the ridge and then four behind it. And they are all being overgrown again by the invasive species, lots of cedar, lots of honeysuckle. We're working to get all of that taken back. So that we will actually have a tool. We have somebody with a tool that will come out. He'll actually be able to grind down a lot of the smaller undergrowth that we need moved. This hill over here, you can actually see we've actually cleared a lot of this. There's some honeysuckle over there still, but most of the cedars are gone. This very tall cedar right here we will keep. That is a natural or native cedar as opposed to the little invasive ones. So this is our project. We are trying to accomplish this whole thing in 2 years rather than the originally planned 10 years. It's going to cost a lot of money. It's going to take a lot of effort. And fortunately, I have a really great group of people helping to support this. A lot of own horses that live here or have ridden with us for many years. And we are moving forward, hopefully, with some good pasture restoration us to be self-sustaining. So that's it. Have a good day, and we'll talk more soon.